Okay, we are going to continue with the error control coding in terms of cyclic codes. This is what we have studied yesterday. In that we have introduced something which is a subclass of the linear block code, in which it is following two specific properties of linearity and cyclic property. By cyclic property, what we meant is that any cyclic shift of a code vector will generate another code vector, which was missing in case of linear block code. And also the linearity property says that the addition of two code vectors will generate a third code vector, which is also one of the code vectors within the set. So this was followed by the representation of the code vectors in terms of a polynomial representation. Again, this polynomial approach is specific to cyclic codes, and I told you that for all the cyclic codes related problems or numericals, you are supposed to express everything, that is starting from generator matrix, parity check matrix, parity matrix, even the code vectors, everything in terms of a polynomial. And in that way, VX was given by the first set where it is representing a code vector. In this case, we will not say the code vector, we will call it the code polynomial. And that code polynomial for non-systematic cyclic codes, we were generating in the following process of multiplying DX, that is being the message polynomial. Again, the message vector gave rise to message polynomial, and we multiply that with a generator polynomial, which is again representation of the generator matrix that we had for linear block code. So multiplication of, like in case of our linear block code, if you can remember, we did find C that was equal to M multiplied by G, but M and G both were in terms of an array or a matrix. In this case, the matrix won't be there. Instead of that, there will be a polynomial representation, and also the polynomial functions will look like a specific option. For example, the code vectors will look something like this: v0 plus v1 plus v1x plus v2x square, like that, where v1, v0, v2, whatever the values, this can be either 1 or zeros. Based on that, we have to generalize the polynomial, and also the orders or the maximum order up to which it can go, that also we have discussed. Finally, we have taken one numerical in which the given polynomial, the generated polynomial was given, and for the given set of inputs, okay, what should be the respective code vectors, that is what we have found out using the technique. And based on that, we have also found out that the representation of 1 plus x square plus x to the power 5, or from lower to higher, or from higher to lower, it will depend on how the gx is provided to you. Like in this case, the gx is provided in terms of x to the power 0 here. So the lower power is in the left hand side, and right hand side is having the maximum power. So our dx, our cx, all will be designed in this order. Okay. So based on the general polynomial, we have to arrange it. And based on that, we have found out the code vectors also. Then what we did, that we finally finished off with some of the properties of the generated polynomials, which in fact can be tested from the given example as well. And finally, we ended up our discussion on this note that we will find the code vectors now for a systematic form. By systematic form, what we meant is that we have a portion of data, okay? We have a message portion. So the message will be followed by the parity bits. So this was the, so this is my message and this is my parity bit. So the same way like we did for linear block codes, now we are going to do the systematic code vector generation for a cyclic code. Okay. So let's start, and we have found out that this is also the expression of generating this Px, which is the parity check bit polynomial we call it, or the parity bit polynomial. Again, the parity bit we won't call it, or parity bit or a parity matrix we won't call it. We will call it the parity polynomial or parity bit polynomial. So let's start from this point. Okay. So let us write it once. Right. So we'll start off from this point that P of x is given by x to the power n minus k multiplied by dx divided by g of x. So this is my formula leading towards the calculation. So let's take directly an example and we try to solve it. Question is, please try to solve this. Find the all the code vectors for the code. Find all the code vectors for the code in systematic form given the generated polynomial for a 7,4 cyclic code is g of x equals x cube plus x plus 1. Okay. So given 7,4 or n, k as 7,4 and g of x is given by x cube plus x plus 1, find the code vectors in the systematic form. Okay, that's the question. So let's start one by one by the process that is involved with this. Any one is sufficient. We'll try out with doing two, three different messages. The process will be same. So first we'll go a detailed process for one single message. Then let's see what happens with the next. So first of all, here what we have already been given as the data. So n equal to 7, k equals to 4. So your n minus k is equal to 3. This is a good practice because you never know how and when these elements will be needed at some point of time. So I request you, whenever you are solving for both linear block code questions or a cyclic codes question, please write first that what is n, k and n minus k. Because later on you might it might be helping you at some point. So this is my n. So naturally there are 2 to the power k messages. Or 2 to the power 4 message, that is 16 code vectors possible. So we are not going to evaluate all, at least we will try to evaluate some with respect to the message. So our gx, the process is the same, so we will focus on the process itself. So gx is given by x cube plus x plus 1, whereas the dx is given by dx we can't know, we don't know because we have not been given. Suppose our message is given by 0101. So let us write it over here for the message 0101. So this is the message, that is input message. Because naturally we require an input message, otherwise this equation will not be existing. So I need a dx. So dx should be given. So the message, suppose we take 0101. That will be given either, or suppose in this case is not given, you know that for 4 combinations of symbols, this is one of the case. So you can also try with 1010 or 1000, anything. I am just taking 0101 as one of the example. We'll take another few more, in fact. And if not given, you can take anything. And if it is given, then naturally you are going to take that. So in this case, suppose it's given 0101, you need to find the systematic code. So your dx, which will look something like, can anyone tell me what will be dx? If your dx is like this, 0101, not dx, but ideally the bit pattern is like this. Can anyone give me what will be dx? Dx we have already introduced yesterday, actually. So, can I write this 0 multiplied by x cubed plus 1 multiplied by x square plus 0 multiplied by x to the power 1 plus 1 multiplied by x to the power 0. So, this is kind of the scenario. X to the power 0 we are not writing, we are directly writing as 1 for most of the cases. So, the option that we are getting is some kind of an x square plus 1. So, again, I must redirect to you to yesterday's example. Dx is already given. Dx we have already defined something like this. So, your dx was looking something like this. And this dx is what we are representing in this case as well. Okay. So, our dx is x square plus 1. Now, as for the formula, please find out what is given by x to the power n minus k multiplied by dx. The first half, the top numerator part, what is you are evaluating for? So, your x to the power n minus k is x cube. N minus k, in this case I have written already, it's 3. So, your x cube multiplied by x square plus 1, which gives me x to the power 5 plus x cube. Simple, its process is very simple actually, but this is will be followed for all the cases. So, this is my numerator part. Okay. So, let us expand this. This is the step you will forget now. So, please make a note of it. Now, what we are going to do is, this we will represent or we can at least write in this way, x to the power 5 plus 0 x to the power 4 plus x cube plus 0 x square plus 0 x plus 0. This is how it is happening inside. We are not representing it, we are only representing, we just need this one. I am just talking about that this is what the internal structure of the polynomial should be. But it's not needed. We only need x to the power n minus k multiplied by dx. So, our gx can also be extended to x cube plus 0 x square plus x plus 1. Can I write this too? Please check once. These two equations, can I write? We have the equations already set up with the elements whatever we have to expand that because now we are going to divide. For division purpose, you have to take all the elements, even if it is 0, you have to take that into account. So, this is the expanded part of gx and that is the expanded part of the numerator part. So, let's divide. Okay. So, division would look something like this. So, simply you do this, x cube plus 0 x square plus x plus 1 divided by, divide the whole segment, x to the power 5, 0 x to the power 4 plus x cube plus 0 x square plus 0 x plus 0. Simple as that. You just have to divide, you have to make sure that the quotient and the remainder you are collecting correctly. Because that will have a role to play in finding the quote vector. Okay. Now, as far as the division is concerned, I'll show you one in detail. Rest of the things are almost the same. So, basically what you have to do is, this is the first term x cube. So, naturally you have to give an x square over here. So, I'll do this way. X to the power 5 plus 0 into x to the power 4 plus, see how I'm doing it. You have to also do the same process. Even if you understand like what will be the current corresponding result, but this is a better option. I'm going to the details, okay? So, x 0 x square, so we have 0 x to the power 4 plus x cube plus x square, okay? Now, you have to subtract. The way we are doing the normal subtraction. Now, for modulo 2 addition, like we have done, modulo subtraction is nothing but the addition itself. Okay, so that is something like x to the power 5 minus x to the power 5. You think of this way. So, we are segregating this one out. Now, here you can see x to the power 4, if I take common, it becomes 0. So, 0 plus 0 is 0. So, this also goes out. x is cube, if you take common x is cube, then 1 or 1, it becomes 0 once again. So this also doesn't exist. Now you are having this one. So this is 0 plus 1. Even if you are doing a subtraction, please remember we are doing an addition. Because it's a modulo 2 addition we are doing. So basically what is happening over here, x square 1 zor this plus 0 x plus 0. This is what the result is. Now this 1 plus zor is nothing but 1. Hence the x square will remain. So I'll write not this, but I'll write x square plus 0 x plus 0. Right? Now again you can see, since we have reached this point, we cannot divide it further. Because the highest power here is x is cube. So we can't go anything. So we'll take the remainder. So remainder is, so if I write once again, x to the power 3 dx by gx, the one that we did, produces a remainder x square plus 0x plus 0. If this is what we are getting, then we will consider our px as p of x, or the polynomial, parity polynomial, as p2x square plus p1x plus p0x, like that. Or sorry, p0 multiplied by 0, because it's x to the power 0. So basically we are looking at 1, 0, 0 as the elements. The polynomial equation is given by p2x square plus p1x plus p0. Okay? Because you can remember, if I go back to yesterday's class, I think at the end I have discussed that what will be the nature of p. So this p is the nature. Okay? So p0, p1, p2 up to pn minus k minus 1. So here n minus k is 3. So 3 minus 1 is 2. So your highest order will be 2. So you can check here, we have checked this as p of 2. So p2 x square plus p1 x plus p0 0. So this is 1 0 0. Hence our code vector, what we are following is, first will be the message, next half will be the parity. So your first message is 0 1 0 1. And your parity bit is giving us 1, 0, 0. Hence, this is our code vector in systematic form for the input 0, 1, 0, 1. Any doubt up till now? I'll repeat once again. Or should you practice with another one? Okay, so I give you one data. Suppose the input message is 1, 0, 0, 1. Suppose, using the same process for the same set of elements, suppose your message 2 is 1, 0, 0, 1. Can you find out, first of all, the remainder, okay? Just in the same manner, because your gx will remain same, so don't need to worry about with that. Only the thing is that dx will change. Okay. So, again dx, if you can remember, that was again d of k, if I am not wrong, k or n minus k. If I go back, d has the maximum element up to n minus k, up to k minus 1. So 4 minus 1 is 3. So your power of d should be maximum of 3. So ideally your equation should have something like this. X is cube plus d2x square. I am writing the general one. d1x plus d0. This is what the general equation of d should be. Now since you are having 1, 0, 0, 1. So you can substitute like this. 1 x is cube. 0 x square 0 x plus 1. So this can be one option, and in that case x square and x is becoming 0, so you are left with x is cube plus 1. So your input polynomial or the message polynomial is coming as x is cube plus 1. Everyone is clear why this x is cube, why it is not x to the power 4? Because if you go back to yesterday's lecture, we had discussed that d of x should have the highest power of d to the power n, d to the power k minus 1. Since this is a 7 comma 4, so your k is 4, so 4 minus 1 is 3, so your highest order of d should be 3. So you start from d0, d1, d2, d3. Can anyone tell me if would have been an example for 6 comma 3, which is also a very common one, what should be the value of d we can take? D0, D1, D2. That's it. So the same numerical can be done for 6,3 as well. But it's a waste of time. We have to do the same process. So this is my dx. Your gx is already given. The detailed gx. So if this is x is cube, okay, tell me one thing. If this is x is cube plus 1, so what will be the expanded version of dx? Or rather, we have to multiply x to the power n minus k with this. So that is x is cube. So x is cube multiplied by x cube plus 1. So x is 6 plus x is cube. So can you expand that? So we'll expand it in this way. So you have 1. 1 is not needed in this case. X to the power 6 plus 0 into x to the power 5 plus 0 x to the power 4 plus 1 x to the power 3 plus 0 x square plus 0x1 plus 0x0, something like this. So this is my expanded one. Divide and tell me the remainder that you are getting. Remainder 0. Let's see, wait. Anyone? X square? Not matching. Let's see. X square
plus
X. X square plus X. That's what. So your quotient for this, the remainder for this one should be X square plus X. Should I have to do the division part for you? Should I do it? You tell me. Don't feel ashamed if the division is not going to happen with you. I can do that also. But the process of division, please remember to take the common. I think many of you might be having the error if you have not taken common elements. So take the common, check that whether the modulo 2 addition is giving us a 0 value or not. If it is 1 plus 1, it will be 0. If it is 0 plus 0, it will be 0. Except for 0 and 1 or 1 or 0, it should have some value. So your remainder in this case is coming. I'm just keeping it because you are confident. So remainder for this is coming around x square plus x. Okay. So if this is x square plus x, so again we rewrite once again n minus k t of x g of x. This is coming as x square plus x. Can anyone give me the parity bits? 1, 1, 0. That's simply because p2 x square plus p1 x plus p0. Now p2 is considered to be 1. This is 1 and this is 0. Hence we can write the bit pattern as 1, 1, 0. Hence our code vector or the systematic code vector should look like 1, 0, 1 and the parity is coming as 1, 1, 0. So this is my 7 bit cyclic code for 7,4 systematic code. Is it clear? All? Good. So similarly you can check for any other message. Okay. Suppose the question is as it is given, like find the all the code vectors for 7,4, then you have to make a table in which m0, m1, m2, m3, you have to consider all the 16 patterns that is possible. And then for each and every message element, you have to find out what is the code vector by following the same process. Right? Now, if I know the code vectors, okay, now we should be knowing about the parity matrix as well, like or the generator matrix as well. So, how to generate the generator polynomial? Because up till this point, we are almost considering in each cases, what is the generator polynomial? So, let's see how to calculate the parity check matrix as well as the generator matrix out of a polynomial expression. Okay. So the next part is we'll go to a new page maybe. So the topic is generator and parity check matrix of cyclic code. Now you can see from the polynomial state we are going back to the matrix form. So you can imagine the rest of the process will be same. So suppose you are trying to find the parity check matrix H, which will be nothing but the parity matrix given, right hand side will be the the identity matrix 1 0 0 0 1 0, like that. So all the process will remain same except that the generator part is only different. Okay, so first of all we'll start this way, that for the generated matrix naturally it is of size of k cross n. So maybe I'll write it once again. So the generator matrix has a size k cross n and is represented in this form. Again, we start with a general description, we'll go to a numerical once again. So your g of x is usually looking like x to the power n minus k plus g of n minus k minus 1 x to the power n minus k minus 1 plus dot 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 g of 1 x to the power 1, okay, this may be the scenario that we can have. Ideally what we'll do is we'll do a multiplication of x to the power I in both sides. What exactly is x to the power I, I'll tell you. So after doing that, what we are going to do is x to the power I g of x is given by x to the power I plus n minus k plus g of n minus k minus I, sorry, this will be 1, x to the power I plus n minus k minus 1, like that it will go on. Now what is the use of this then? This I will vary, where the I will vary like this, k minus 1, k minus 2, dot 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 up to 2, 1, 0. So from the half, the I which is we have multiplied, that x to the power I we are just multiplying to g of x, and where I stands with these elements, okay, k minus 1, k minus 2, it will go down, 2, 1, 0, like that. Now let's take a direct example. Why we are doing this? Again, the general part won't be used, only the numerical is important. So take this example, obtain the generator matrix. See the change. Last day we did it with polynomial. Obtain the generator matrix corresponding to, so this is a question. So obtain the G matrix or generator matrix given gx is x cube plus x square plus 1 for a 7,4 cyclic code. So the question is, you have been given a polynomial. Now you have to go back to find the generator matrix. Okay? So generator matrix means that there is row and column. So if you ask me, like, sir, we can expand this using polynomial function and that will give you only single row. So now you have to find out all the row element. So how you are going to do it? So the process involved is something like this. It's easy again. So in this case, your n is 7, k is 4, your n minus k is equal to 3. So if this is the case, so we'll try to form x to the power I multiplied by gx. So it is x to the power I plus 3 plus x to the power I plus 2 plus x to the power I. Can I write this? Gx is given by x cube plus x square plus 1. So you multiply this by x to the power I. So you are becoming 3 plus I. So that is what this part is. Square plus I. So 2 plus I. So this is 2 plus I. anyway x to the power 1 is x is not there, so you are having 1 over here, so it's basically multiplying this and we are coming up with this. So this is my general equation, right? Now what we are going to do is, since this is very important step actually, since k is equal to 3, oh sorry, k is equal to 4, okay, so your k minus 1 is nothing but 3, so you can see, if I just go up here, we have started from the element k minus 1, so I should vary from 3 to 1, 0. Repeating once again, this I value, this I what I have referred here, it varies from k minus 1, it starts from k minus 1. For our case, k is 4, so 4 minus 1 is 3, 4 minus 2 is 2, and the rest is again naturally 1 and 0. So you will find your I values are given by 3, 2, 1 and 0. So we have fixed up the x to the power I multiplied by gx, and we have also found out the I. Now what we have to do is, we have to substitute I. Each and every I will give a pattern of the expression x to the power I gx, meaning x for row 1, for row 1, substitute I equals to 3, where in this equation, suppose I write this as equation 1. So what we are going to do is, x to the power 3 gx is equal to x to the power 6 plus x to the power 5 plus x is cube. Am I clear with this, people at the back? What we did, we have generalized an equation here at equation number 1. Now we have defined what are the values of I. Now we are substituting each and every case, and by considering the fact that the first or the highest element will give us the first row elements of the G matrix. Okay? So our I3 is giving this I2 x square gx, it will look like. So your x square will look like x to the power 5 plus x to the power 4 plus x square. I equals to 1 will give x to the power 1, so that x actually gx is equal to x to the power 4 plus x is cube plus x. And finally, when I equal to 0, what are the elements? So it is only gx. What are the elements here? X, x cube plus x square plus 1. So basically we have multiplied all the combinations of I with that of gx. Now what we have to do is, we have to expand each of this row. Each of this row we need to expand. How? So the first thing is x is cube gx. So we'll expand this way. X to the power 6 plus x to the power 5, or maybe we can write this way. 1 into x to the power 6, 1 into x to the power 5, 0 into x to the power 4, 1 into x cube, 0 into x square, 0 into x plus 0. Okay? So if this is the case, because this is again very similar to the configuration of gx that we have defined earlier. If you can remember, there also we did the same. So similarly, x square gx can be given by 0x6 plus 1x to the power 5 plus 1x to the power 4, 0x cube, 1x square plus 0x plus 0. X is gx is given by 0x6 plus 0x5 plus 0x4 plus 1x cube. Oh, sorry. This should be 1. This should be 1, I guess, no? Third one? Yeah. This should be 1. Okay. This won't be there. X is cube plus 0x square plus 1x plus 0. And last but not the least, the gx part will be 0x6, 0x5 1 x squared plus 0 into x plus 1. Because it's 1, it is not carrying any element. So it would have been, if it would have been x, then we could have put 0, 1 over here. So these are the element. Now the generated matrix will be nothing but taking the coefficients from each of this element. So your G matrix will look like, take each and every row, take their coefficients. So 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1. So that becomes your generator matrix for this process of linear block code of 7,4. Now as you can observe again in the same manner, if it is a 7,4, so your total elements are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So your n is satisfied, your k is 4, k 4 means that 1, 2, 3, 4. So these elements are all your message part. So you need to have an identity matrix. So that also is present over somewhere over here. Sorry. You can't find the identity matrix in this case because this is not a linear block code. It's a circular, it's a cyclic code. So that's not the linear. You can imagine the elements are there, but basically it's a cyclic code. So you cannot really experience the unity matrix or identity matrix there. So this is your generator matrix. So if this is again known to you, can you find for x is cube plus x plus 1, if this is given as gx, can you just tell me what are the elements you are getting for each and every row for the given same example? Suppose the generated polynomial is now given as x is cube plus x plus 1. For the same set of elements, can you at least give me the 4 equations? Because here also I will be 3, 2, 1, 0. So can you just give me the 4 equations? First one. Row 1 elements of the equation. So x is cube multiplied by gx. This one I need. So what will be the general equation x to the power I multiplied by gx? X to the power I multiplied by gx. So x to the power I multiplied by x is cube plus x plus 1. So it basically becomes x to the power I plus 3 plus x to the power I plus 1 and x to the power I. So this is your general equation. Now by naturally substituting I one by one, you can get the different equation. Like the first one should be x to the power 6 plus x to the power 4 plus x is cube. Similarly, you can go ahead with the others. Okay. Is this correct? Because row 1 x is cube. So if I put 3 plus 1 is I is 3 here. Okay. Yeah, that's correct. Similarly, you can get the other rows. Okay. Can anyone give me the rows quickly? Second row, x5, x3, x square. I'm just asking for this. X to the power 4, x square plus x1. And last one will be x cube plus x1 plus 1. Like that. It might come. Again, you have to expand that and get the respective G matrix. If you know the G matrix, you can multiply that with any message vector and you can get the code vectors corresponding. So the process is again the same. So that's what. So you can see, suppose you want to find out like this, m multiplied by g. Now you take any value of m, suppose 1, 0, 0, 1, and you multiply by the g that you are getting over here. So the same process, just like in linear block code, you consider in the same manner you can find the code vector as well. So if the code vector polynomial is given to you, or the generator polynomial is given to you, and you are asked to find the code vector, it's easier to use the earlier process rather than this to find out. This is specific to when you are asked to find the generated matrix. If it is asked, then only you are following this. Otherwise, the earlier method is fine. X to the power n minus k dx gx. Right. So the last one that we have to do is, so this is how we generate the generator matrix for the non-systematic code vector. This part. Okay. Now we are going to systematic code vectors once again. So systematic code vector generator matrix. So systematic form of G matrix. So this is again the second method, like we did in the earlier case. Code vectors were generated for non-systematic, then we did the systematic. Similarly, systematic form of code vector generation. Now again, this is also purely done using a formula which will look something like this. We are only focusing on this because you have to do the problem itself. So you don't have to waste on much on the theory. So basically what we are going to do is x to the power n minus t xor of rtx is given by qtx g of x. What are these elements? This is again the same process just like we did for the code vector generation for parity, for systematic code vectors, the same way. Here t indicates 1, 2, 3, ... up to k. RTX, this is indicating the remainder. So again, it is assumed that there is some kind of a division that needs to be performed. Then you have QT, which is the quotient part. And GX is again the generator polynomial. So you have this element. Now how you are going to find it? Let's again take one example and we'll try to solve. This is, remember, the systematic code vectors that we are trying to generate. So again, suppose the question is, find out the G matrix for a systematic 7,4 cyclic code if GX is given as X is Q. If GX is given as X is Q plus X plus 1. Okay, and based on this also you can find out what is the parity matrix for the given set. So we will do this way. We have to follow the equation. So in this case again, if I write n equals to 7, k equals to 4, this is again for 7,4, it's already given. So n minus k is equal to 3. So our t should vary between 1, 2, 3, 4, because it varies between 1, 2, 3 to up to k. So your t element value, t instance value will vary between 1, 2, 3, 4. So what we are going to do is, for t equals to 1, okay, t equals to 1, please write down the equation that you are looking at. X to the power n minus t. What is n minus t? N is how much? 7. 7 minus 1, 6. So x to the power 6, some kind of a xoring here, r 1 x equals q 1 x, x is q plus x plus 1. This is the first element of the first entry that we can get. Similarly, you can have the next one as t equal to 2, which should be like this, x to the power 5 r 2 x q 2 x x cube plus x plus 1. So it will go on for all the four entries it will be there. Now suppose I want the first only, because the rest will be same. So let us do this. To find out R1x and Q1x, what you have to do is, to find out Q1x, Q1x is nothing but x to the power 6 divided by x cube plus x plus 1. What we are going to do is, we are using this first equation. We are trying to find out what is this remainder, R1x. So what we can do is x to the power 6 divided by x cube plus x plus 1. So that will give us some value of the quotient as well as the remainder divided by the gx. Okay, so let's check this one. So this will be represented as x6 plus 0 x5. Okay, all will be 0 itself. So x4, x cube, x square, x plus 0. So all will be 0. This divided by x cube plus x plus 1. So we divide x cube plus x plus 1, x to the power 6. So the first thing will come as x cube. So that means x 6 plus x4 plus x cube. Now these are all zeros, so no need to worry. So basically this will get cancelled, but x to the power 4 and x to the power 3 will remain, and the rest of the zeros. Okay. So the next entry will be x, because then it becomes x to the power 4 plus x square plus x. Again we do the modulo subtraction in this case. Subtraction is the addition. Again x to the power 4 gets cancelled. So x is cube plus x square plus x and the rest of the zeros. So this is the for last half we can do. So while multiplying x, so x is cube plus x plus 1. So this means this gets cancelled, x gets cancelled, so your remainder is remaining as x square plus 1. So this is your remainder. Okay, so that is what the main idea is. So your t equals to 1 is giving you x to the power 6 plus r1x. Now r1 is giving by x square plus 1. So your element will be x to the power 6 plus x square plus 1. Similarly, for each and every t1, like t2, t3, t4, you are supposed to get some kind of a remainder out here. That remainder you have to add with the respective elements that you are having. So this will be R2, this will be R3x. Okay. So in order to do that, you will find that R2x should come around x square plus x plus 1 after the division. And your x to, and your R3 will be coming around x square plus x. So finally, your G matrix you have to form from the elements that you have gathered. So this will be 1. What will be the expanded form for this? 1 into x6, 0 x5 plus 0 x4 plus 1 x cube, 0 x cube plus 1 x square plus anything else? 0 x plus 1. So your coefficients are 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1. So this is the first row elements for the generator matrix using systematic sort. Right? So this is when we end our discussion. We'll come back next day and we'll start from this point. We'll do another problem on generation of systematic and we'll move ahead with the encoder as well as the parity or the syndrome generation like we did for linear blocks. Thanks.